Sure, good. I've been trying to go online for the past few minutes, but I think this time it works. So I am going to cook something. My sister told me to cook something and there's chicken at home. So we decided to do chicken stroganoff. Let me see how I can put this on silent. I don't even know how to put this on silent. Anyways. So I thought I can go live and show you the way to cook this. I'm gonna cook chicken stroganoff. It's a very easy dish to cook. So I'm gonna start by telling you what are the ingredients that we need and also the way we should do it. Okay, so yalla, I will tell you stuff. While I'm doing it, I will tell you stuff in Arabic. So we will need, of course, the chicken. Djej. Chicken is djej, okay? And it's, we call this djej maqta. Maqta means it's cut into pieces, okay? Djej maqta, chicken pieces, but we're saying cut chicken. But we don't mean cutted, you know what I mean? Cutted chicken, hi Neos. So it's like chicken pieces, we say djej maqta. So haida, this, haida, djej maqta. We will also need mushroom, which is futter in Lebanese. Also, we tend to use a lot champignon in French, okay? So either say futter or champignon, okay? Futter, which is mushroom. Okay, we will also need cream cheese. We tend to use the name of a brand, like we just say Philadelphia, even if it's not, like in this case it's not a Philadelphia, it's another brand, but we just say Philadelphia. But if you want to say cream cheese, you can say jibnet crema. Jibne is cheese and crema, we say crema for cream. But when I'm saying the two together, jibnet, hi Freddy, when I'm saying the two words together, I don't say jibne crema. Why? Because the word jibne, as you can see here on the box, you see it has a te marbuta. I don't know if you see in the right direction. So this is a te marbuta basically. So this te marbuta is usually silent, like the word jibne, siyara, tawle, all these have a te marbuta. The t is usually silent. But whenever I put another noun next to it, we pronounce it. So it becomes jibnet crema, not jibne crema. We call it jibnet crema, or just say cream cheese. We will also need, this one is chicken stock, I think you call it in English. So in Arabic, we call it mar'at djej. Mar'a or mar'a, you see, it's also one of the words that have a te marbuta. So it's mar'at djej. I will not say mar'a djej when I'm mentioning it's a stock of what? It's chicken stock. So I'm saying a stock of chicken. That's why we say mar'at djej. Okay? Hi, Bahar. So it's alone you say mar'a, but if it's you're mentioning a stock of what, you say mar'at djej. Okay, and then we will need mustard. We just call it moutard in Lebanese. Really, we will not say anything else, we just say moutard. And then we have grated cheese, so we call it jibne mabrouche. So mabrouche is masculine, but because jibne is feminine, we have to use a feminine adjective with it. So it's jibne mabrouche. Actually, the word mabrouche is a participle. We call it a passive participle for those of you who are a little bit more advanced. Otherwise, just call it jibne mabrouche, grated cheese. By the way, all these words that I'm using and the instructions that I'm going to be using today, since I am live, I can't write them here on my screen. But I'm gonna write them later on in the description box. So you could still watch the video and you can literally just scroll up with your finger and watch me while I'm at the same time, while at the same time you're reading this. But at the same time, even now live, even if you are You don't see it on the screen. Try to write what I'm saying, and maybe later on you can check if you wrote it correct or not. It's always a very good idea to write things down. So this is salt, ملح, salt. It's written T here, okay? But it's not T. It's not shy. Shy is T. هذا ملح. So بدنا ملح. We want salt. But also I can say عايزين. We need. عايزين. So I'm using بدنا. We want or عايزين. We need. بدنا. Hi, Yusuf. Big juice. Check my friend's channel, Big Juice. If you want to improve your Egyptian Arabic, he does like fun videos. He's not an Arabic teacher, but if you want to have a good ear for Egyptian Arabic, go check Big Juice TV. He just signed in and I just said hi to him. Okay, so عايزين ملح or بدنا ملح. عايزين, we are the needers of literally, which means we need. عايزين ملح or بدنا ملح. And هيدا بصل. بصل مفروم. مفروم is like cut into very small pieces. Okay, مفروم. هيدا بصل مفروم. It's مجلد. مجلد means frozen. It was frozen, so which makes life easier. So هيدا بصل مفروم ومجلد. Frozen. كان بالفريزر. It was in the freezer. We just say freezer. كان بالفريزر. You can also use the word تلاجة for freezer. تلاجة. Literally icer, which makes things iced. تلاجة or freezer. So هيدا بصل مفروم. كان بالفريزر. It was in the freezer. وكمان بدنا نبيد. نبيد is wine. نبيد. I don't even know if it's no. نبيد أبيض. White wine. Okay. نبيد أبيض. كمان عايزين نبيد أبيض. وهيدي كريم فريش. Literally just say كريم فريش. We just say it in Lebanese as well, although it's French. Okay. Fresh cream. كريم فريش. عايزين كريم فريش. رح استعمل. رح استعمل means I will use. رح استعمل لتر. رح استعمل لتر. I will use. رح استعمل. رح استعمل لتر كريم فريش. وكمان عايزين زيت قلي. زيت قلي. زيت means oil. قلي means frying. If you want to say we need oil for frying, you say بدنا زيت قلي. We want frying oil. زيت قلي or زيت للقلي for the frying. It's the same. زيت قلي or زيت للقلي. So I will put the stuff there in the other direction. Actually, I'm gonna keep it here and I will put the camera a bit lower so you can see what exactly I will be doing. Okay, so here. So you're not gonna be seeing my face, but more the food for now until I mix them. Okay. So, شو هيدا؟ هيدا جات. So هيدا جات. This is a pot basically. You can also say تابروير. That's how we pronounce it in the Lebanese way. Although it's a brand, I think in the Frenchy way they say تابروير. Some of my Frenchy Lebanese might say that, but I just say تابروير the Lebanese way. Tupperware or jat, but it's a jat, it's a bowl. Okay, so هيدا جات. So oh, I forgot the cutting board. I will get it. So هيدا جات. رح افتح means I will open. رح افتح الجيج. As I said, you might not see my face. It's okay for now, yeah. So هيدا جيج مقطع. رح افتح. I will open. رح افتح الجيج. I will open the chicken. راح افتح. I will open. راح افتح الدجاج. راح نحط. It's been ages I didn't cook, let alone I didn't cook this food. بس هيدي أكلة كتير كتير هينة. This is a very very easy food. هيدي أكلة كتير كتير هينة. هينة يعني easy. I use the feminine form هينة because أكلة is a platter or a food, it's feminine. I didn't say أكل, food, أكلة, like a platter. هيدي أكلة كتير هينة. It's a very easy dish. Okay. هلا رح ناخد we will take رح ناخد ناخد is we take رح ناخد is we will take. So hi to Poland I think. Okay, so رح ناخد المطارد we will take the mustard ورح نحط we will put رح نحط. So رح ناخد we will take رح نحط is we will put رح نحط شي ملعقة أو ملعقتين we will put one spoon or two spoons. So ملعقة is a spoon. It has a T مربوطة. I didn't pronounce it. I said ملعقة. But now I'm gonna say ملعقتين because I want to say two. Anytime you wanna say two something, two of something in Arabic, you add the N at the end of the word. But in this case, because the word has a T مربوطة, ملعقة, it has a T مربوطة, but I don't pronounce it. But when I add the N, I will have to pronounce it. I say ملعقتين. So I will add two spoons. Or رح نحط, we will put, رح نحط ملعقتين. لأنه كتار, because they are a lot. You see, I said كتار. I didn't say كتير, because كتير is singular, but chicken here is plural. That's why I said كتار. So even adjectives in Arabic have plural forms. Okay, so I said رح نحط, we will put ملعقتين. Two spoons, لأنه كتار. Actually, I'm gonna add more. Two and a half or three. رح نحط تلاتة تقريبا. تقريبا means around. رح نحط تلاتة تقريبا. I feel like a chef, but I'm nowhere near being a chef. So, حطينا تلات ملاعق. شو اسمه؟ حطينا. حطينا is the past tense, okay? حطينا. We put. Literally, you're saying as if we put it. Of course, it doesn't make sense, but you know what I mean. So, حطينا تلات ملاعق مطارد وهلا رحت ملح. رحت. I will put. رحت ملح. I will put salt. بعد شوي. You know, I noticed salt in Lebanon and salt in London are different. The ones in London, they don't give you a lot of salty flavor, but the ones in Lebanon, they're more salty. So يلا خلونا نخلطن نخلطن خلونا let us, okay? Let us together. خلونا نخلط is we mix. نخلطن the un in the end means them. خلونا نخلطن. Look, they look nice already. خلونا نخلطن. You see, I should have a cameraman next to me holding the camera and me doing my job properly rather than you guys seeing half of me and half of the food and all of that. But you know, أحسن من بلا. أحسن من بلا means better than nothing. أحسن, better, من, literally you're saying from, and بلا means without. أحسن من بلا, better from nothing, literally, which means better than nothing. أحسن من بلا. Okay? I usually mix this with my hands, but today I'm pretending to be polite and using a spoon because I fixed my nails 2 days ago and they're already, the color is already chipped, but I don't want to make it worse. So هلا now عم نخلطن. We are mixing them. So initially I said رح نخلطن, we will mix them, and now I said عم نخلطن. I'm sorry, I'm not seeing all the messages. I will check them later on when we have a little break while they are frying. Okay? So, هلا now خلطناهن. خلطناهن يعني we mixed them. خلطنا is we mixed. خلطناهن with the on in the end means we mixed them. So when I'm saying we mixed, I'm saying خلطنا with the a sound in the end. But when I'm adding the un, them, in the end, I'm not saying خلطناهن. No, in Lebanese we tend to add a sound. We say خلطناهن. So if it's alone, I say خلطنا, we mixed. But if I want to say we mixed them, I say خلطناهن, not خلطناهن. Okay? So خلطناهن. Oh, sorry. وهلا رح نقليهن. One second, let me get the tissue. So هلا راح نقليهم. Actually راح غسل ايدي. I will wash my hands. راح غسل ايدي, my hands, I didn't say إيديني, although إيدين is the plural form. But I say رح غسل إيديي. I don't say إيديني because although إيدين is the plural, whenever we have a noon in the plural, we have to drop it before putting the my, which is the e. So إيدين on its own. إيديي, not إيديني when it's my hands. So رح غسل إيديي وأربط and tie وأربط شعري. رح غسل إيديي وأربط شعري. So شعر is hair, شعري is my hair. أربط is I tie. رح أربط is I will tie. So رح غسل إيديي. Guys, when I'm saying something or a sentence or anything, say it out loud with me. Be active. Don't be passive while you're learning. Because if you say things or if you write them down, your brain retains the information for longer and you become a faster learner. So رح غسل إيديي وأربط شعري. That's what I said. وهلا now عم بنشف. I am drying. عم بنشف إيديي. I am drying my hands. عم بنشف. Say with me. عم بنشف إيديي بالفوطة. فوطة is like the kitchen towel usually. Okay. عم بنشف إيديي بالفوطة. Okay. Anyways, يلا. هلا رح نجيب. We will bring. رح نجيب. Keep saying with me. Okay. رح نجيب الزيت. هيدا زيت للقلي. This is frying oil, as I said. Okay. زيت دوار الشمس. دوار الشمس is the, how do you call it in English? Let me check if it's written. Yeah, sunflower oil. Okay. So هيدا زيت دوار الشمس. Sunflower means دوار الشمس. So رح نحط شوي. We will put a bit. رح نحط شوي. بالطنجرة. In the cooking pot. طنجرة. Okay. رح نحط شوي بالطنجرة. مش كتير. لأنه because مش كتير. Not a lot. لأنه already الأكلة تقيلة. تقيلة is heavy. It can be heavy in weight like in kilograms and also heavy like when the food is heavy. We use the same adjective. لأنه already الأكلة تقيلة. It's a heavy food. So I used a feminine adjective. I said تقيلة. I didn't say تقيل. الأكلة تقيلة because again, as I said before, the word أكلة. Oh my God, it's difficult to speak and cook and multitask. بس يلا, I will get used to it. Because I'm also a bit nervous. So الأكلة تقيلة already. The food is already heavy. So هلا ولعت. ولعت is I turned on usually the fire, not something else. So هلا ولعت الغاز. I turned on. We say غاز for the hops. We called it غاز, gas. Maybe because we, you know, you can turn it on through gas by using gas. I don't know. So ولعت الغاز. I turned on the whatever you call it in English, cooking oven. No, it's not the oven. It's not. It's just the one on top. Okay. So ولعت الغاز. I turned on the gas. So رحت الدجاج. I will put the chicken. يلا. So ما حطيت. I didn't put. ما حطيت كتير. زيت. I didn't put a lot of oil. So رح أخلطن مرة تانية. I need a wooden spoon. ملعقة خشب. Let me find one. You see when you're underprepared. So رح أخلطن مرة تانية. I will mix them a second time. رح أخلطن. أخلط is I mix. أخلطن is I mix them. رح, let me show you. خليني فرجيكم. رح أخلطن مرة تانية. شو كان بدي أقول? What was I gonna say? ورح دور. رح دور means I will turn on. But you see I used ولع for fire. But now I said دور for turn on. When you turn on anything else, for example, a machine, a car, the light, anything you say راح دور, but for the fire you say راح ولع. So هلا راح دور الشفاطة. I hope it won't be noisy. If it gets noisy, tell me so I turn it off. يا الله نسيت حتى البصل. لحظة بس خلينا نشيلهم. Let me. I forgot to put the. You see, because I'm nervous, I forgot to put the onions. ما عليه. بعدنا مبلشين. We've just started. I said بعدنا مبلشين. We've just started. So فينا نرجع نشيلهم. We can remove them again. Anyway, so I was saying راح دور. Let's go back. So راح دور الشفاطة. We call it شفاطة. Why? Because شفط means like extracting, and shufata means extractor. So if it's noisy, إذا في ضجة. ضجة means noise. Okay, ضجة. إذا في ضجة, if there is noise, إذا في ضجة قولولي. Tell me, you plural, tell me. إذا في ضجة قولولي. So I turn it off again. So دورت, I turned on. دورت, دورت الشفاطة. الشفاطة pronounced as الشفاطة. دورت الشفاطة. وهلأ حطينا, we put, حطينا زيت مرة تانية, وراح نقلي البصل. راح نقلي, راح نقلي البصل. بصل as I said is onions. راح نقلي البصل. We will fry the onions and we will stink. وراح تطلع ريحتنا. That's how you say you will stink. راح تطلع. Literally you say it will come out. راح تطلع. It will come up actually. ريحة is smell. ريحتنا is our smell. راح تطلع ريحتنا. Our smell will come out, which means we will be stinky basically. Okay, راح تطلع ريحتنا بصل. We will stink like onion. We will smell like onion basically. لحظة, لحظة means one second. لحظة, راح جيب ملعقة الخشب. ملعقة الخشب. ملعقة as I said is spoon. راح جيب is I will bring. راح جيب ملعقة الخشب. هيدي ملعقة خشب. خشب is wood. ملعقة is spoon. ملعقة خشب is literally you're saying a spoon of wood, which means this a wooden spoon. So ملعقة خشب. So on its own again the word is ملعقة. It's not ملعقة, it's ملعقة. Thank you. Thank you miss, I don't know what is it, but thank you for the motivation. Somebody told me it's not a cooking show, I'm doing good. Thank you so much. Okay, شكرا كتير. Or we say in Lebanese, merci كتير. So هيدي ملعقة. We didn't say ملعقة, yeah? But because I mentioned wood, the word wood after it, I'm saying a spoon of wood. That's why I pronounce the T مربوطة and I say ملعقة خشب. So هلا عم بخلط. I am mixing. I have to mix it and kind of press on it because it's frozen. So هلا عم بخلط البصل. و actually عم بيدوبوا. They are melting. عم بيدوبوا. بيدوب is he melts. بيدوبوا is they melt in the present form. If I want to make it present continuous, it is melting, I say عم بيدوبوا. I love the smell of onion and also garlic when it's fried. كتير بحب ريحة البصل. I love the smell of onion. كتير بحب. كتير is a lot. بحب is I love or I like. بحب كتير ريحة البصل. I love the smell of onion. I can hear every now and then the sound. Hi Lou. Hearts back to you. I can hear every now and then the sound of my niece and my sister. She's like barely 4 years and they're studying online. So there's always this issue of the online studying, and then she doesn't concentrate and she wants to play and my sister goes crazy. So it's dangerous to go live when there are kids at home because it can go wrong at any given time. Thank you, Petros. So hopefully they will not finish before I finish. But she told me it's going to take just 1 hour and 10 minutes, but we should be done in less than 1 hour. And my other little niece is sleeping, Naime. Bint Ukhti, my niece, so you're saying the daughter of my sister. Bint Ukhti, Naime. The daughter of my sister, Bint Ukhti, Naime. You're saying she's the sleeper, Naime. I use the participle. So when I use the participle with Naime, with to sleep, it means she is sleeping. It's not a verb, but it plays the role of a verb, which is in the present continuous. Okay? So let me know if the shofata, the extractor, is noisy, so I can turn it off, but we would even stink more. Okay, so anyways, yalla, let's go back to the Arabic. عم بخلط البصل وعم بقلي, or I can also say عم بقلي, it would be exactly the same, either عم بقلي or عم بقلي. عم بقلي البصل ورحت, I will put رحت الجيج, the chicken, فوقن. فوق means over or on top. فوقن, on top of them. You're literally saying on top them. فوقن. Okay? وكمان, and also بلمخ. بلمخ means brainless. أنا بلمخ, I'm brainless. كمان نسيت, I forgot, نسيت النبيد. I forgot the wine. لازم نحط, we have to put. لازم نحط نبيد. Okay. So نجاح بالفرن, دجاج بالفرن, لا مش بالفرن, على الغاز. It's not in the oven, it's on top. Okay, so رح نحط, we will put, رح نحط شوية نبيد, a little bit of wine. We can say عن نظر. نظر in Arabic means sight, seeing, the sight. Okay, when I say عن نظر, literally on the sight, literally on seeing. What does this mean when I say عن نظر? It's a way to say you can do something, you can guess something or the amount, how much you put, you can put without measuring it, just by, you know, by sight or by looking at it. So in that case you can say عن نظر. Okay, so for example, you know, sometimes in cooking shows they tell you have to put I don't know how many grams of salt and yeah, thank you for writing nazar. And how many grams of whatever oil, you know? But when we cook in real life, most of the times we don't measure it and we don't even have scales to measure it. So we put عن نظر. So أنا حطيت, I put نبيد عن نظر. Okay? وكمان حطيت حطيت زيت, I also put oil, حطيت زيت عن نظر. I think I was stingy with the oil, I don't know. I'm worrying about getting fat while at the same time my mouth doesn't stop eating. I eat all sorts of chocolates and chips and crap. But anyways, so yalla, راح ارجع اخلطهم بعد شوي. I will remix them. راح ارجع. Okay, look what I said here. راح ارجع. راح ارجع, literally ارجع means to return. Okay, but here I used it with a verb. I said رح ارجع اخلطن, I will return and I will mix them. That's what I'm literally saying, but of course that's not what it means. When you use ارجع before a verb, it will not mean to return, it will mean to redo something. So here I said رح ارجع اخلطن, it's a way to say I will remix them. رح ارجع اخلطن. والريحة كثير طيبة, as I said. The smell is very nice, as I said. الريحة, we can also say بتشهي. بتشهي. I used this in another video when I said بتشهي. بتشهي is a verb. It comes from the word شهية. And شهية means appetite. Okay? Merci, Petros. تفضل. So, Petros said كتير طيب, it's very tasty, and I told him تفضل means we always say تفضل when we're cooking in Lebanon because in our culture we always want to invite people. We say تفضل means come eat with us in this context. Anyways, going back to بتشهي, so I said it comes from the word شهية, and شهية means appetite. When I use the verb بتشهي, I'm literally saying it appetites you. It doesn't make sense in English, but it gives your appetite, gives you appetite. It opens your appetite. It makes you crave, basically. So if I say الريحة بتشهي, the smell is craving, which means it's it makes it looks good, basically. It smells good, okay? الريحة بتشهي. I'm going to check your comments later on because I'm already multitasking and I'm feeling nervous. So I will check the comments later on. Okay, so as I said, الريحة بتشهي وعم نقلي البصل وهلا, and now رحت, I will put رحت, رحت الجيج, I will put الجيج, رح ارجع actually because I put it before and I took it out, رح ارجع حط, I will re-put, رح ارجع حط الجيج, I will re-put the chicken, رح ارجع حط الجيج, ورح خفف, رح خفف is I will reduce, خفف is reduce, رح خفف, I will reduce, رح خفف النار, the fire, رح خفف النار. Hi Cynthia. That's my sister, she came to do some trouble. You see, she said شو هالريحة الطيبة. She said, what is this smell, the tasty, which means what a beautiful smell. شو هالريحة الطيبة. We write it شو هالريحة, but we have to pronounce it شو هالريحة, because the letter ر, ريحة, ر, is a sun letter, so we don't say الريحة, we say الريحة. شو هالريحة الطيبة. Anyways, going back to what I was saying رح خفف النار, I will reduce the fire. رح خفف, خفف is to reduce النار, the fire. رح خفف النار ورح اتركن, رح اترك is I will leave. رح اتركن, I will leave them. Okay, so رح اترك with the O is I will leave, but if I want to add the on in the end, the them, رح اتركن, no, I'm not going to say رح اتركن, we will pronounce it رح اتركن, رح اتركن, I will leave them. رح اتركن شوي, a little bit, ما بعرف قدي, I don't know how much, ما بعرف is I don't know, قدي means how much, ما بعرف قدي, I don't know how much, I will leave them, بس منشوف, we will see. Let me get the cover. رح جيب الغطا, I will get the cover. رح جيب, I will bring. رح جيب الغطا, I will bring the cover. رح جيب الغطا. Okay. So, رح سكر, I will close. رح سكر عليهم, I will close on them, which means I will close it or I will close them. So I literally said رح سكر عليهم, on them, okay? رح سكر عليهم. يلا guys, say all the words with me, yeah? So رح سكر عليهم, I will close on them, which means I will cover them or I will close them. وهلا, and now, رح أس. أس is I cut. رح أس is I will cut. رح أس ال champignon or الفطر, as we say in Arabic, okay? But we, as I said, we use a lot the French word for فطر, which is champignon. رح أس الفطر, I will cut the mushrooms. Now here I will say عم بأس. You see, initially I said رح أس because I was using the future tense, but now I'm saying عم بأس, I am cutting. عم بقص الشامبينيون أو عم بقص الفطر. If you want to use a proper Arabic word, you can say شرحات. شرحات is like slices. شرحات. Okay. شرحات. So I'm cutting the champignon. I'm cutting the mushrooms. Yeah, if you have a question now, you can ask now because my brain is a bit more focused. No, we don't write it عم بتقص. We write it with a صاد. Okay, عم بقص. So I will write it with a ب, قاف, and صاد. Why do I write it with a قاف? Because you know that 99% of the times, maybe in Lebanese Arabic, we pronounce the قاف, the letter قاف, as a أ, as if it's a hamza. So that's why I didn't say عم قص. I said عم بقص. There are actually some Lebanese people who continue pronouncing it as a قاف, like the Druze of Lebanon. They pronounce قا. They don't pronounce أ. But generally speaking, the more common way of pronouncing it in Lebanese Arabic would be as if it's a hamza, أ, بأس. Okay? So I could have also used another verb. Instead of أس, I could have used عم بأس إس. There is a difference between أس and أس إس. أس is just to cut. أس إس is like cutting into pieces. So I could have said رح أس إس, I will keep cut. It doesn't exist, but you know what I mean, as if you are saying you are cutting into pieces. So I will رح أس إس or عم بأس إس الشامبينيون هلا قصيتهم. Now I cut them. So look, I said عم بأس إس, I am cutting. رح أس إس, I will cut. And now I said قصيت, I cut them in the past. قصيت, that's how you say it in the past tense. أنا قصيت, I cut. هلا قصيتهم ورح زيدهم. زيد is to add. رح زيد is I will add. رح زيدهم with the on in the end is I will add them. رح زيدهم على الجيج, I will add them to the chicken. رح زيدهم على الجيج, I will add them to the chicken. And I will put you back up here so I can see you and you can see me. This is my stand for the camera. So, what did I say? رح زيدهم. شوفوا شكلهم. Look how they look. شوفوا شكلهم is I said look at their shape. شكل. That's how you say look how they look. Look at how they look. شوفوا شكلهم. We don't mean their shape, but like look at the way they look. شوفوا, you plural. شوفوا, شوف is masculine. Look, شوفوا in the plural. شوفوا شكلون. شكل is shape or their look. شكلون, their look with the on in the end. شوفوا شكلون. Look how they look basically. شوفوا شكلون. رح ارجع اخلط مرة تانية. I will remix another time. رح ارجع اخلط مرة تانية. مرة تانية literally means a second time. Okay? A second time. But it means another time. رح ارجع اخلط مرة تانية. وكمان and also وكمان رح ارجع زيد. I will re-add. رح ارجع زيد. زيد means add. رح ارجع زيد نقطة نبيد. نقطة means نقطة. It means a drop of. نقطة نبيد, a drop of wine. So here you notice I pronounced the T مربوطة because I mentioned the word نبيد with it. I'm saying a drop of wine. نقطة نبيد. I will not say نقطة نبيد. But in another context, when the word, sorry, not in another context, when the word is alone, I pronounce it نقطة. But it's followed by another noun, a drop of wine. That's why I pronounced نقطة نبيد, not نقطة نبيد. In another context, نقطة means a point or a dot. For example, if you're writing a passage and you want to add a dot, you say نقطة. But here, it's not a dot, it's a drop of. For example, if I'm thirsty, I say رح أشرب, I will drink, رح أشرب نقطة ماء. I'm not drinking a drop, literally, but it's a way to say just a little bit of نقطة, نقطة. Okay? So by the time we wait for this, because we just need to add the cheese, الجبنة, المرقة, the stock, the chicken stock, مرقة الدجاج, and the creme fraiche. Okay? By the time I wait for this, I will read your comments. I will wash my hands again and I will read your comments. رح غسل إيدي. Or I can say, as I said, رح إرجع غسل إيدي. Right? Because إرجع is ري. رح إرجع غسل. I will rewash. رح إرجع غسل إيدي. My hands. ورح أحكي معكم. I will speak with you plural. رح أحكي. I will speak. رح أحكي معكم. I will speak with you plural and answer your questions. يلا. Let's see. Do you have any questions? عندكم أسئلة؟ Let me see. How do I read the previous comments? I don't even know how to read them. Let's see. If you have questions, write it down. Now I don't know how to reread the questions before. يلا. أنا ناطرة. I am waiting. أنا ناطرة. In the masculine form, you say ناطر if you're a guy. If you're a girl, you say ناطرة. Look at her. She's putting a big effort, you know, not to be annoying, because usually the house is like, and I gave them a warning, please don't come to the kitchen a lot. Please don't do this, don't do that. And they're trying. How to say it's so yummy? كتير طيب. كتير طيب. So I was saying ناطر. If you're a guy, you say أنا ناطر. I'm waiting. If you're a girl, you say أنا ناطرة. بشوم كتير شهي مزبوط. Yeah. Oh my God. It's disappearing the comments before I read them. I should find out how to reread the comments. I'm sure there is a way, but I don't want to click on something by mistake. Let's try. No. Okay. يلا. مين عنده سؤال? Who has a question? رح قوي النار actually. رح قوي means literally I will strengthen, which means I will put the fire up. Okay? رح قوي. Now the word قوي, the verb is قوي. قوي, to make strong. But قوي is I will tell you. قوي means strong as an adjective. قوي with a shadda. There is a difference, yeah? قوي means strong. قوي means to strengthen. So رح قوي النار. I will increase the fire, but I said I will strengthen the fire. ورح أخلطهم كمان. I will mix them again. بيشهوا. What's بيشهوا? I told you. بيشهوا. Yeah, merci Petros. بيشهوا is they make you crave. يسلم إيديك يا طباخة. إمتى ترجع لندن أنت تمريني؟ مرسي. يسلم إيديك. He said yes. أوي and no. أوي. The shadda should be on the wow. So if somebody cooks, by the way, and you want to say thank you to them, you say to them يسلموا إيديك if it's a guy. And if it's a girl, it's يسلموا إيديك. Now I told you a while ago that إيدين is the plural word. إيد, one hand. إيدين, plural, hands. إيدينك, we don't say that. Yes, Petros. We don't say إيدينك. We say إيديك, your hands. And إيديك, your hands, feminine. يسلموا, may they be in peace or safety or healthy. So يسلموا إيديك, may your hands be healthy or say, may they have safety or may they be in peace, basically. It's a way to say thank you to someone who cooks for us. So, so when somebody cooks for us, we say يسلموا إيديك or يسلموا إيديك. But it's not just for cooking. Anyone who helps us doing something with their hand, using their hand. If somebody carried my bags, for example, if I was shopping in the supermarket and somebody helped me carry my bags to the door or to the car or something, I say يسلموا إيديك. I can say that. Or يسلموا إيديك. So خلونا نرجع نخلطهم. Let's remix them. It looks kind of ready to add the So جاهزين means ready in the plural form. You notice we are even making the adjectives plural. So مبينين جاهزين. They look ready. مبين is in the singular form. It looks. جاهز ready. مبين جاهز, that's in the singular form. It looks ready. مبين جاهز. But in the plural form, I will say مبينين جاهزين. So I'm using participles here. Don't worry too much about participles if you're not advanced. Just memorize them as adjectives. They look ready. جاهزين. Okay? مبينين. They look جاهزين. Ready. I'm literally saying they are the lookers and they are the readies. Just say مبين جاهز if it's masculine. مبينين جاهزين if it's feminine. If it's plural, sorry. If it's feminine, you say مبينة جاهزة. You add a T مربوطة. مبينة جاهزة. Oh my god, I have to sit down and write all of this now after class. This is my maybe longest lesson ever. It's 45 minutes now. Okay. يلا. So, هلا رح نحط, we will put or رح نزيد, we will add الجبنة, the cheese. So, عم بفتح, I am opening, عم بفتح, I am opening, عم بفتح, عم بفتح العلبة, I am opening the box, عم بفتح العلبة, وهلا رح حط الجبنة على الدجاج, I put the cheese on the chicken. حطيت, now it's the past tense, حطيت الجبنة على الدجاج. بحب عادة, usually I like, بحب عادة حط, I usually like to put, بحب عادة حط علبتين, علبة is one box, علبتين, you pronounce the T مربوطة when you add the N, علبتين is two boxes, so بحب عادة حط علبتين, I usually like to put two boxes, بس ما في بالبيت, or ما كان في بالبيت, there wasn't at home. ما كان في, there wasn't, which means there was no two boxes, okay? So, let me repeat what I said. بحب عادة حط, or I can also say عادة, usually. عادة بحب حط, usually I like to put. عادة بحب حط علبتين, two boxes. بس ما كان في بالبيت, but there was no at home. بس ما كان في, there was no. ما كان في بالبيت, there was no at home. اوكي يلا هلا رح زيد الكريم فريش and now I will add the fresh cream. We say just creme fraiche. This is the part that makes it the tastiest and also the heaviest and the fattiest. هيدي الأكلة كتير بتنصح. بتنصح means it makes fat, which means it's fattening. It's like it's very heavy. It has lots of calories. بتنصح, I'm saying. So, بنصح is in the masculine form. If it's something masculine that makes you become fat, بنصح. بتنصح, it's she makes fat, which means it's fattening, okay? هيدي الأكلة كتير بتنصح. This food is very fattening. But the way you're saying it is, هيدي الأكلة, you're saying, بتنصح, it makes fat. Okay? So, عم نحط هلا الكريم فريش. So, حطينا الكريم فريش. بعد عنا المرقة. We still have only what do you call it? Stock? The chicken stock. We call it مرقة in Arabic. بعد عنا بس المرقة. Okay, we only have the chicken stock. So هيدي أول وحدة. This is the first one. هيدي, this feminine. أول, first, وحدة. One. This is the first one. هيدي أول وحدة. حطيتها. I put her, which means I put it. حطيت. I put حطيتها. Is I put it, I put her. وهيدي and this, هيدي تاني واحدة. This is the second one. هيدي تاني واحدة. كمان حطيتها. I also put it. يلا خلونا نخلطهم. Let's mix them. And This is the end of our platter today. It looks very simple, but it's really, really, really tasty. كتير كتير طيبة. You have to add cheese on top. It would be very nice, and cook rice next to it. So when it's finished, what I usually do is I cook rice. بطبخ. I cook بطبخ رز. Oh, finish. I can also say بعمل رز. Like it's not like a big platter or cooking something. That's why I don't usually say بطبخ رز. I say بعمل رز. I do رز. Which means I do rice. بعمل رز. حدن. حدن is next to them. بعمل بتنصح. بعمل رز حدن. I do rice next to them, which means we eat it with rice basically. وبحط جبنة على الوجه. And I put cheese. Literally you're saying on the face, which means on top. بحط جبنة على الوجه. Okay, so we use على الوجه. It's a nice expression, memorize it. So بحط جبنة على الوجه. I put cheese on top, which means on the face, which means on its face basically, on the face of the food. وبحط جبنة على الوجه. Okay, so هيدي هي الطبخة. This is the هيدي هي الطبخة. This is the platter. Okay, I think I clicked by mistake. I went off by mistake. So هيدي هي الطبخة. This is the dish. طبخة is a dish basically, because it comes from verb طبخ, to cook, and طبخة is something that's cooked. Okay, that's why it's a dish. So هيدي هي الطبخة. This is the dish or the platter. إن شاء الله تجربوها. I hope you try it. تجربو is you try. تجربوها is you try her, which means you try it. You know, in Arabic we don't have it. That's why it's stroganoff. That's why we use you try her or you try him. So إن شاء الله تجربوها. I hope you try it. وتحبوها and you like it. تحبو is you like. تحبوها is you like her. إن شاء الله تجربوها وتحبوها. I hope you try it and you like it. So, as I said, let me just very quickly say how you will eat it. بتحطوا مع رز. You put with it rice. بتحطوا is you put messy. مشكين. بتحطوا مع رز. You put with her or with it. مع. بتحطوا مع. You put with her. بتحطوا مع رز وبتحطوا الجبنة على الوجه. And you put the cheese on top. حيلا جبنة بتحبوها. Any cheese you like. So I use the word حيلا. حيلا means any cheese. حيلا جبنة any cheese. حيلا جبنة بتحبوها. بتحبوها is you like it or you like her. Any cheese you like. حيلا جبنة بتحبوها. هاي ميشا. I'm using here three cheese, but you can use any cheese you want. Okay. هيدا كل شيء لليوم. That's it for today. إن شاء الله تكونوا انبسطتوا. I hope you enjoyed it. يلا, I'll give you a couple of minutes. If you have any questions, يلا ask me. And I'm gonna try to respond before the comment disappears. يلا. حدا عنده سؤال? Anyone has a question? وخبز? لا, بلا خبز. Without خبز. خبز means bread. لأنه already في رز. There's already rice. So بلا خبز. Without bread. بس إذا بدك تاكليها مع خبز. If you want to try it with, if you want to eat it with bread, you can try. I don't know. Usually I don't eat it with bread. We don't eat it with bread. مين بعد عنده سؤال? Who has a question? Should taste it. Okay, so لازم is we should or we must. لازم, if you want to say I should taste it. One second, I made a teacher very grateful. Love this family. Thank you, Petros. Okay, so somebody asked me, how do we say I should taste it or we should taste it? If you want to say I should taste it, you say لازم, which means I must. لازم do, I should taste. Do is to taste. Do a is taste her. لازم دوقة. I should taste her. Literally, that's what you're saying. I must taste her, which means I should taste it. لازم دوقة. لازم دوقة. Yes, it will be saved, of course, Bahar. يلا I miss you, come to class. And then if you want to use it in the plural, you say لازم ندوق. We taste. So do is I taste. ندوق with ن before نون. ندوق ندوق is we should taste it. لازم ندوق. Noisy is we usually say it in a way that there is noise. في ضجة. We don't say noisy. We say there is noise. في ضجة. ضجة. I will write them later on. Okay. في ضجة. There is noise. كان في ضجة. There was noise. Tell me if there was. كان في ضجة. Merci, Misha. مين كمان عنده سؤال؟ يلا I will give you one more minute before I go if you have any questions. حدا عنده سؤال؟ Anyone has a question? ولا بهر you watched all of it eh? حضرتيها كلها. Let me show you one last look. It looks really yummy. شفتوا؟ اوكي منيح ما كان في ضجة. There was no noise, that's good. Okay then, if no one has a question, I will say bye. إذا ما حدا عنده سؤال رح لكم bye. Okay? يلا بشوفكن مرة الجاي. I see you next time. بشوفكن مرة الجاي. Bye Petros. شو كلكن شهيتوا؟ All of you are now with an appetite. شهيتوا. That's the past tense. شهيت. أنا شهيت. I appetited, literally it has no meaning in English, but you're saying my appetite opened. Merci Mishka, or I hope I'm saying your name correct. So أنا شهيت, أنتو شهيتو, you plural had an appetite. شهيتو, you, because you were watching me. So أنتو شهيتو. Okay, يلا bye guys. Bye. يلا قولوا bye تسكر. My cheeks are red because I think I was a bit nervous. Yalla, bye. La, we will not write it shahayt. It's a T. It has. Oh, Rosie, you can watch it later on. Hi, Rosie. So it's shahayt. You write it with a T, sheen, with a fatha. So the T has a skoon. T, sh, with a fatha. He, ye, and T. شهيت بدي تدوق اوكي يلا باي جايز باي باي